Hey yo, it's Brandon Lauren. Welcome back to Rome Total War as the Thracians. If you remember last time, we really pressed our advantage against the Greek cities and started to take some of their cities. I think we took Athens with that. Zaios took Athens after a nice battle there, and today I think we will siege attack Sparta. Perhaps siege attack some other cities, and just keep dominating everything. because that's what us Thracians do, you know? And, here we go, loading up. Indeed, Drenis is sieging Sparta. Kind of funny, the guy at Salona here, his name is also Drenis. So Drenis is sieging Salona, and Drenis is sieging Sparta. So we got double Drenis all the way across the sky. And, I don't know if I've mentioned that, but we do have double Drenis action. And, this Drenis up here, we might siege attack with him. I'm not sure. The Julii are trying to attack here at Tarentum, and that'll be a snooze fest, I'm sure, because, it's just a bunch of Samnite gladiators, and we've established that those guys are pretty easy to kill. So, and the turn, Dacians are going to try to break the siege here. They only have one unit coming in. So it's one unit versus five units. They have six units versus, 15. I don't know. I guess they're really desperate, which makes sense because I think they still probably only have towns. They don't even have any large towns, so they really need to try to keep them. And poor Dacians, but they're just kind of in the way, so we're gonna take them out. It's kind of our plan of attack. The day has dawned. And this is kind of this map is kind of ugly. It's ugly, man. Look at this. We got a major downslope action there. It looks pretty, though. I'll give it that. And we're going to position up here with our infantry. For this battle, folks, we can be on the front lines because, we're fighting barbarians, so the Falksmen will still be useful in the front lines. And we don't really have that many hoplites or phalanx troops. I mean, we don't actually. Oh, we do have a unit of militia hoplites. Oops. guess I screwed up the line a little bit there. I have to reformat that. Move everybody else up here, and then we're ready to go. Oh yeah. Barbarian noble cav over here in the woods. They're not hiding, but not that I really needed them to. I'm gonna spread out these guys and. I'll just put the Volksmen behind. Doesn't really matter. Keep the archers behind there. Turn off skirmish mode and engage. The secondary army is coming in from down there. So actually, I think I'm going to move our army to meet them. Because then we have the hill advantage. And we'll take our cavalry over here as well. And I'm pretty sure our five units of militia cav can take out one warband, right? Right. So we'll go do that. And that should be a nice cleanup with that. And look at these sexy horsemen with their headbands and their horses and their people. I don't know what I'm saying. Anyway, they're going to engage here. We're going to watch them, make sure they don't do anything too stupid. And there we go. Just pepper them. Just ruin their lives. Ruin their lives. Oh, what are you doing? What? I hate skirmish mode so much. I hate it so much. It never works. Oh my gosh, they skirmished into them. They skirmished into them. What the heck? Ugh. Oh well. Okay, we lost one unit. We didn't lose that many men in the unit, but it's routing. Hopefully it doesn't route into this army. I don't think it will, but that's just dumb. Anyway, we need to run our phalanxes up there because the rest of our army got there a little too soon. We got to really pay attention to their troops here. And we'll put down the line here and have them attack. Put these guys down, have them attack. Put these guys down and have them attack. And move our barbarian noble cav back. We don't want them engaging the war bands if they don't have to. And these guys came back from routing. You guys can go back up here. go harass them with missile fire a little bit. And they're down to 42 men, so that's pretty good. We could probably engage a melee attack and be pretty successful, so that's what we're going to do. And pause it here. It looks like they're engaging with the warband and our general, but we'll engage Cry Command. We'll charge at the warband, which will separate, and then we can take out their general. Actually, they separate their general as it is, so we should be able to take them out with one unit. With two units of Barbarian Noble Cab, we should be able to. And it looks like the one warband died, and we should be able to take out these guys pretty easily, I think. There we go. We did lose a lot of men in that one cavalry unit, though, unfortunately. But, there we go. Their whole army decided to rout, so that's pretty nice. They're a little close to the border, so we probably won't be able to take them all out, but we can try. And Falksmen, you know, Thracians and Falksmen go hand in hand. Just cut them down. Just you know, deliver some blows of justice to those Dacian dogs. And it should all be good from there on. And we've clearly won the battle. We might take the settlement here. We might not. I don't know. They seem to have a lot of guys left. We'll see in a second here. They have 92 guys left. There's a chance that we'll be able to take it, but I don't know. I think it has to be like 5%, but I'm not sure. Less than 5%. I don't know the numbers. I don't know the math behind the... No. Alright, they're still there. That's fine. We'll wait another turn or two. We'll draw out some more of their forces. And we don't really need that guy. He's a little old and doesn't have good enough traits. We have plenty of commanders. And now Pontus is the richest faction. Oh, we got two. Speaking of which, we got two more ones. This guy's ugly. But he's a good builder. So... Yeah, he's a pretty good... He'll make a good governor with some good traits. The superior builder is a good way to start. So we'll send him over to Thessalonica. And he'll learn some good traits there. Because I think we have an academy there. I'm not sure. If we don't, then oops. But, No biggie. Oh, and we got a new guy down here, too. He's got overprotective Nanny. Nanny knows best. Interesting. He's got a lot of traits for being 16. He looks like he's a good ruler, but it doesn't look like he's going to have any kids. Flaccid. Flaccid refers to, erectile dysfunction. Let's just say that and be done with it. And, also built a unit of Phalanx Pikes. I was going to say Falksmen. What are you doing, man? They're not Falksmen. They're Phalanx Pikes. And we're going to send Xyles out. I think we're going to send Xyles towards Thermon. And then Drenis can clean up Corinth after he's done with Sparta. That's kind of what my game plan here is. And then the Greek cities should be eliminated. Civil War complete. And you should see our cash flow just going up. Because, you know, since we have all this trade, we have a whole peninsula which is, just offers so much trade. And especially we can trade with the other peninsula. We can trade with Asia Minor because we're on good terms with Pontus. And we're going to trade with our colonies in Italy that we've taken. And, you know, I don't think I'm going to attack Pontus in this LP. We need to get on to other things. There's plenty of games to play. And, yeah, I'll do a long campaign eventually. I think if I'm going to do a long campaign, I'd rather do it as the Romans because it's very conducive to have a long campaign because it's just a lot easier to have a long campaign as the Romans. That's all I'm going to say about that. Because you're not constantly fighting defensive battles. You're not on war at all fronts, usually, unless you go to the Civil War. But that's later. But that's a totally different boat. That's another subject. And, yeah, I can't delete this. Oh. I think it is time to siege attack Sparta. This could be interesting. So, let's engage. Of course, they have the dangerous Spartan hoplites, but we have definitely the advantage of numbers, and we have some Bastarnae to hit them in the backs. Bastarnae also have 2 HP. Spartan hoplites, probably the best individual stats of any soldier. They have, I think, 17 attack, 18 defense, and 2 HP. that, yeah. Yeah. And I always say, if you have 2 HP, you pretty much double the defense stat. That's my view on it. So it's more like they have, you know, 36 HP or 36 defense. So, yeah. See, that's not really true, because if they have, like, say they have 10 defense, they can take 2 HP of damage a lot easier than other things, you know. They'll take 2 HP of damage faster than a unit with 20 defense would take 1 HP of damage. I don't know what I'm saying. anyway, we're just going to send the ladders up to attack Sparta here. And Norton is performing background tasks. Again, Mr. Norton needs to stop being a poop-a-doop, because this is not very nice. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? Okay? Hey, Saul, you know what he's saying? No, I don't know what he's saying, Saul. They do have Peltas on the wall, but again, they're very easy to take down. Even with Phalanx pikemen in sword-to-sword combat. And look at these guys. Look at these Spartan hoplites. They are just sexing it up over there. That's, I forget what skin mod I put on. It's the same mod that gives us captains that look like standard generals. But it was some skin pack mod, and it gives you a bunch of custom battle maps as well. I don't remember what it is. I know Prince of Macedon uses it, and that's what I was like, oh, this is pretty nice. So I decided to get it. Not a real big change, just a couple little things. And I'm pulling in my siege tower so I can fire at these Peltasts, as the Peltasts fire at my guys. And yeah, siege towers can be used as offensive, you know, artillery, kind of. And it's interesting, because when you have bigger walls, this guy is so loud. And, as I was saying, if you have bigger walls, the siege towers actually upgrade and turn into like ballista siege towers. It's kind of crazy. Anyway, our flying spikemen are going to engage these Peltas. They should be able to take them out pretty easily. They do have nice. They have decent short swords, and the Peltas do not have good melee skills. So, yeah. Sorry about that, guys. I had to go do something really quick, but I am back. A little bit out of breath, but I'm okay. Anyway, we're engaging the Peltas, and we should be able to take them out. I'm going to take these guys here, move them across the wall, take the towers, and do the same with this guy. And I think we'll probably just take out all the towers so that we don't have any chance of getting shot by them. I think that'll probably be the best bet. These guys will be exhausted, but you know, we won't really use them, so that's fine. And we're going to take everybody off the siege equipment and then send unit accretion archers in, and then we'll send some phalanx pikes in, and then we'll probably send our general in. That'll probably be the best bet. So that's exactly what we'll do. And, you know, I decided not to take all the towers. You know, there's really no point. But I thought I might have. But, you know, I decided to pull them down on the streets. It is what it is, you know. But you probably won't use them in combat, because they're injured and tired and stuff. So, anyway, everybody move up to this meeting spot right here, and then I believe we can take the road, this road here. Yeah, that looks like it works. Okay, these large cities can be a little hard to navigate, but we got it. The computer definitely knows how to navigate them, but not using their whole army at a time, though, which is kind of silly. Kind of really silly. Really silly. Really silly. And, Drenus and his men moving up. And, still don't know how Drenus got that gold chevron. It's pretty nice, though, because it makes his unit pretty tough to kill. And, when we hit the Marner forms, we'll get the better general's bodyguard, and they'll be even harder to kill. But, hopefully they don't hit the Marner forms soon, because that means the Romans will be able to hurt us pretty bad, so we don't want that. But we'll move our phalanx pikes here. And then we'll move the creation ashes in front. And then we'll then move our general to the right flank. And then we'll move our bestiary to the left flank. I don't know what accent that was, but it was one. And this is probably my idiot accent, honestly. Yeah, it's pretty humid today. Oh, I guess their general is deciding to ambush us. But he's only militia cav, so I'm not too worried about it. Our phalanx spiking can take him down pretty easily, even if they decide not to deploy their phalanx. There we go. They weren't deploying their pikes for some reason. There we go. Took out their general. We got Bastarni in there a little bit, which is pretty nice. And, yeah, we should be able to take them out. Move our Bastarni over. Make sure our phalanx spikes are in the right spot. I guess, was phalanx spawn not engaged for some of them? Maybe not. I don't know. Maybe that was the problem. Keep Drenus here, and we'll have the Cretan archers should be shooting down their general. And that'll be nice. Actually, to maximize their effectiveness, we should group them like this so that they can all shoot down the street corridor. That would probably be the best idea. And I'll put down our pikes just in case they decide to charge in. And, yeah. Just let our Cretan archers shoot down their general, and then possibly shoot at the Spartan hoplites as we bring in our army to take them out. These seven units should be enough to take down units of Spartan hoplites. Should, I say. But probably still take decent casualties on our phalanx pikes, to be honest. And Bastarni. I guess they're deciding not to come out, so we're just going to shoot them down slowly. Might as well take them out while we're not threatened, as opposed to taking them out when we are threatened. Take the advantages when you can get them, man. That's what I say. And there we go. Taken down, and then we'll move the troops in here. Can't shoot the Spartan hoplites, remember, but those sexy Spartan hoplites. And we'll take off phalanx mode temporarily so that we can run in there, because we don't want the Spartan hoplites to decide where we fight. We want to decide where we fight so that we can defeat them. And we'll move the Cretans over here and move the Bastani over there and Drenus right there. And that should be good. Make everybody run but Drenus, so that the slower troops, because, you know, Drenus is fast, can get there first, and then Drenus can just walk up there. Because Drenus kind of, you know, horsemen can kind of, you know, move around their troops and disorganize them. So our Cretan archers should be firing, and we'll get Drenus to run up here. And we'll get our phalanx pikemen to move in to try to destroy them. Right there would be a good spot. And then we'll go on normal speed. And get our Bastarni to go flank them in the Riach. And we'll turn off fire at will mode. Just have the Cretan archers chill here. Phalanx formation activate. Engage them. And you guys need to move back here. Engage Warcry and then charge at them. And we should be okay. Here are the Spartans. They are fighting. They're already starting to lose some men, which is good. But they are starting to take it. Oh, look at the damage they're doing on that phalanx unit already. And we got Bastarni in the back. And they are doing some good work on these Spartan hoplites. So we should be able to take them out. But they are doing a number on that phalanx unit there. And, yeah. The Bastarni are definitely cutting through them very, very nicely. Because, again, even though Spartans are Spartans, they're still not quite as good with their swords as they are with their spears, so hitting them from the flanks and back is still very effective with infantry. Although they are a lot better with their swords than other hoplites and stuff, but they're not quite as good as they are with their spears, again. So their tech set kind of lies when they're forced to use their swords. So that's why we're doing this without taking too many casualties on our Bastarni. That unit of phalanx pikes almost down to half health, so they did do a good number on them, but looks like we are able to take out these Spartans without too much trouble here. And the glorious, once glorious Spartans have now been taken over by the now glorious Greeks. The now glorious Thracians. And the Bastarni celebrate as they are now the best Greek 2 HP unit in this game. Do-do-do. Of course, you know, Spartan Hoplite 1-for-1 against Bastarni unit would totally wreck it. Unless the Bastarni can get really lucky and hit him in a flank somehow. But again, we're going to occupy the rest of these Greek settlements because we really don't need the money anymore. And not exterminating them will give us a lot more income later on. But we're going to retrain our troops here. And then perhaps move out next turn. Move out next turn against our aggressors. And we can also retrain up in Tarentum, so we will do that. Right there, and that is pretty much all of our money for this turn. We can train one more unit here as well. Throw down a Falksman, why not? And that's looking pretty good. And, yeah. Everything else is looking pretty decent around here. No big deals whatsoever. And stuff is going round. We're going to build a spy in Tylus just for defense against, you know, the Greeks still have some assassins around. So, you never know. You got to be careful. And this guy does not want to retreat. He wants to stand there. We'll let him stand there. And we'll work a ring around him at some point. And we're going to save it and end the turn and see what goes on. Maybe the Greeks will attack us and we can clear them out. Oh, Dacia with a nice large force. If they would have waited, you know, it's a lot better force. But if they would have waited and attacked us, you know, if they would have waited another turn and combined that warband, you know, they could have two decent sized armies attacking us instead of just, you know, two kind of crappy armies attacking us in two simultaneous turns. But that is the problem with the AI in Rome Total War. They don't realize that. They just try to defend with whatever they have at the moment. But, you know, that's okay. And we're going to send the pikemen's up here, kind of like we did last time. This is the same exact map, except that it's summer now because we've passed 6 months. So, it looks a lot different, but it is the same map. Be assured. And again, we're gonna take the Falksmen in the front line this time. And we're going to have the archers back here. This time, however, the big army's going to come down there. And then the behind us will be the one or two warbands. So it's a little opposite setup as far as seasonal and socio-economic pressure. I don't know what I'm saying. Anyway, I need to take a drink, so I'll be right back. The enemy have brought more men to fight. Here we go. Move our line forward. I'll take a couple militia cav and engage that guy. With the hill advantage, the javelin should be doing quite a bit of damage. And I'll take the rest of the militia cav and go harass the incoming army. And hopefully we can do good work like that. And there we go. Move up a little bit more so they can get good javelin throws. And then they should be able to take out this unit, I believe. I would hope. They only started with like 90 men, so it's not too bad. And they're under attack. Doing pretty good damage. A couple more volleys, and they should be down to maybe 20 or 30. Perhaps 40 guys left. And these guys are skirmishing. Hopefully they don't get stupid mode and, you know, charge into the enemy warbands. But you never know. They probably will, actually. I shouldn't say that. And Phalanx is looking good. The setup is looking good. The archer should be attacking soon. We get a lot of missile pressure on this army, which is very nice. You always want the advantage in missile pressure. If you watched our Pontus LP, that was the definitive factor in defeating our opponents in the Pontus LP, was the fact that we had extreme missile pressure. And this unit is weakened, so we're going to charge it with our militia cav. Take some casualties, but we take it out. And this unit's down to 40-ish guys. We have, as I surmise, we have a little bit of javelins left, but I think charging now would be good when our guys are separated. So we'll work around it, that unit there, and we'll be able to charge it from both angles and should be able to take it out. Just kind of making sure everything's good over here. Turn on skirmish mode, run them right there, and then they shouldn't die. They can micro themselves, basically. Micromanage themselves. And we're going to charge in there, and then we're going to charge in here, and there we go. That army is dead. We should be able to take out this. We want those guys to chase them down so that we can get the city next turn. That should be sufficient, so we're going to move all of our militia cav behind the enemy lines here. And they got a general and maybe five or six warbands here, five left. So, We have 5 infantry units and an archer unit and plenty of cavalry. We definitely have the clear advantage. I don't think they realize that. And what are they doing with their general? Their general, they're sending their general right into the death trap here of militia cav. So we're going to engage him. And, you know, he doesn't have any upgrades. Again, he can pause and right-click the unit to figure out that, and those are his base stats. So I know that he doesn't have any upgrades. And we should be able to take him out, hopefully, pretty soon. We'll lose a few number of militia cav, but in my opinion, it's worth it to take out an enemy general. And there we go. And if we could take him out, that would be awesome! Militia cav, I think, are a little faster than normal cavalry, so we'll let him chase him. And perhaps... Oh, yes! There we go. Nice. Nice. We killed the Dacian commander there. They must not have too many family members left. They gotta have, like, 2 or 3. So they can't be throwing them away like this. They lost 2 in 2 turns there, so probably wasn't very good. And now we're going to work our way around these warbands and move our militia cav behind our army. We really want these warbands to engage our line. That's kind of our goal here. Meanwhile, our archers should be picking off a few of them. There we go. Firing at the enemy column. Very nice. And the warbands look like they are falling into our trap, and they're going to try to run up here and engage us. That is perfectly what I wanted them to do. They still think they can win somehow. I'm not seeing it. Are you guys seeing it? I don't see any way they can win. I don't know what they're doing. They're crazy. They're crazy Dacians. I probably could have sped these battles up, but you know what? It's nice to have a good real action carnage fest once in a while in the open field. So, let the blood spill, as I like to say. And I'm gonna warband, or we're gonna war cry to hit the warband with. And if they stop running away, that would be nice. And we're gonna pull over one of our phalanx pikes, and we should be able to engage. There we go, very nice. A little bit of our friendly fire from the archers. That's fine, man. No big. And we're going to engage another unit there. This unit can go engage that unit, and that should be their whole army, I believe. And everybody's routing because they lost their general. So they're like, oh, boo-hoo, we lost our general. Oh. Oh. And we're going to pull back our cav. And we need to take out this unit of Vorband. We should be able to do with our Falksman here. It should be a nice little crush. Hopefully. There we go. Very nice. And they can engage the second unit here as well. Falksmen are very good at taking down warbands. Because they have enough defense to take down their attack, and they have plenty of attack to just slaughter the warbands. And taking some casualties on the Falksmen, but not too many. And we're going to run through them with our cavalry, because they're routing. And that must be their last unit that came back from routing there. So we're going to engage him, and he should be able to get cut down, and we should win the battle. Against Dacian's going to triple speed it, because there's not really anything. There we go. Continue battle. Run them down for their insolence. And yes, Greek guy, that's what I'm doing. And cut down their warband here. And I think, yep, there we go. Clear victory. You men deployed almost equals kills. You are a successful commander. And courage may be taught as a child is taught to speak. Thank you, your pie days. Euripides. There we go. We'll occupy Suggestica. And, Northern Greece is almost totally ours now. We almost have the Balkans pretty much under our control. We just need to take Salona. And then we'll have them in... Oh, wow. These are pretty dorky zone of control there. Guess we can't move past them. Well, maybe next turn we can move towards Thermon. I would rather not engage this Greek army. Because in this area, there are some serious high grounds that they'll probably get to take advantage of, and I don't want them to have that kind of advantage. I don't want Xyles to face that kind of problem if he doesn't have to. So I'm just not gonna do it. And they can't really do anything about it because they don't have enough men to do anything about it. So we're gonna disband that really small unit of dudes. They do have a Temple of Nike. That is a temple that we share with the Greek cities. Is the Temple of Nike. So we don't have to do anything about that one. And we can train some phalanx Pikons, and perhaps next turn move out, or now, I don't know, think about it. You know what, I think we can move out now. They don't have much garrison, and we can just leave you know, one or two phalanx pikes here. And it'll be fun. And maintain the siege. I don't really have plans to engage that settlement, so I'm not too worried about it. And we'll keep training in Athens, keep training in Sparta. They're a little unhappy because they have large population sizes, but not much garrison. And there's their faction leader. Their faction leader must be in Thermon then, and then they have their third family member just chilling out. And they do have, that's where they're training their Macedonian cav from. So, yeah. And the faction announcements look good. And Porlissum has grown into a loyal Greek large city. Thank you, Porlissum, for joining our empire and reformatting yourself to become a Greek city. So we just need Campus Scythiae and Campus Isiages to become loyal Greek cities, and then we'll pretty much colonize the Balkans. I don't really care about the small barbarian towns. That's not really a big deal to me. But I believe Segestica is a Greek city, or a Greek town, so that's nice. And Rhodes is looking pretty good, still growing. And enemy army routes, recruitment report, everything is looking pretty good. And there's some ships and stuff. And it looks like the Julii ran away. I don't know what they're doing. Or did they do that before? I have bad memory sometimes. Anyway, we're going to save it. And I think we're actually going to siege attack here. Captain Kayaz is going to try to defend himself against us. But I think we can take him down. There's no need to speed this up. We haven't siege attacked the Julii before. And this could be interesting. They have some siege equipment and some heavy infantry in the city. So that could be made a little more interesting than normal. But future engagements of the nature will be sped up. And especially as we approach the end of the campaign, which we might be soon. Things will start being sped up and a lot more auto-managing will happen. Yeah. I usually like to auto-manage at the end of a campaign when I'm assured of victory. Because there's really no point in fighting those battles. And we got our onagers here in front. We're going to pretty much just bombard them inside the gates. First, actually, we're going to take down these ballista, though, with our normal rocks. As ballista can take down onagers. I don't know if it takes multiple hits for them to take down an onager, but I know onagers take them down one hit. There we go. One of them down. And we'll wait for the second one to die. And we'll probably actually knock down that wall in the meantime. They killed one of our engineers. That's fine. It looks like they're trying to use flaming ammo to burn our onagers. That would make sense. But we are able to take down their ballista with our bullets. So now we'll turn on flaming ammo. And we'll engage their main column of units there. And with flaming ammo, should pepper the whole city. Just keep it on triple speed the whole time. We actually might be able to blow open the gate during this procedure. That would be nice. Just an added bonus. Then we don't even have to use our rams at all. And there we go. We are able to take out their general. So that's pretty nice. And we're burning some of the town. That's always cool. So very nice. And just kind of bombarding the city, getting as many casualties as we can before we run in there. Have them target this unit of Sam Knights. If they can get some... There we go. There is a nice one. I really like onagers for siege attacks. Onagers just make things so much awesome. And there we go. They did break open the gates, so we don't even have to use our rams. We have an opening in the wall, opening in the gates, so we can get in two different ways. And that's ideally what you want. You don't want to go in it only in one direction because they can hot gate that. So, you know, two is fine. And they're out of ammo, so now we're going to drop the ram and get everybody into the city. We'll take as many guys as we can because, you know, why not? So, Drenus the Second will come up here. I'll call him Drenus the Second because we got him secondly. And, that's a good name for him, right? And we're going to move up here, turn off Phalanx mode, and have him run. And then I believe... Well, we'll put it on normal speed, and then I'll decide what we need to do here. I think the best strategy here... Oh, these guys are getting shot by the tower here, I guess. Here comes the yard! We'll move these Phalanx pikemen here. And we'll move these folks from here. These folks need to take out these town watch really easily that are trying to blockade us. And there's really not much pressure on the main gate as far as blockade goes. So we'll move all our phalanx troops probably through there. And just put all our phalanx troops in front of this gate and we'll move them in a couple units at a time. And then the Falksmen should be able to take out these Town Watch and the Ballista Engineers, who still think that they have Ballistas to operate, I guess. I don't know. But that should work in our favor. And then we'll be able to get into the city, just kind of drive them down the streets, take down the town center, you know. You know. You know. And we're going to engage now. We're going to attack... Oh, they have some Cavalier Exile. Okay, I was wondering why we were taking casualties from Missile. I didn't think that we had anything to do that from. So, these Phalanx Pikemen, we're going to send them in. And these Phalanx Pikemen are going to attack these 5 units of Town Watch here. Should be able to take them out pretty easily. And these Falksmen should make very quick work of these Town Watch and Ballista men. And that, indeed, they did. And now they have to engage. Looks like they're going to engage these Principes. We want to engage them before they fire their Pila, ideally. And we did take out the Cavalry Exile on the way, so that's very nice. Looks like their whole column is routing. We did take out their general, I remember, with the Onager shot. So, I mean, their morale is already staggered from that. And they might still have the morale penalty from the artillery fire itself. So, move our way into the city, turn on triple speed, because we don't need to watch us just filtering into the gate, grappling in there. They can't even get close to us without routing, so not too worried. And, of course, as soon as they say that, they do, and start getting some missile fire off on it. Warcry once again, and we're going to engage the column here with Samnite Gladiators and all that jazz. Put down the Phalanxes, and we should be able to cut these guys down really easily. Yeah, again, they're routing very, very nicely. Very nicely, definitely very nicely. And we should be able to push down the streets with these Falksmen and take out a lot of men. It's kind of my goal here. And let's say they're defending the plaza with a unit of pretty healthy Samnite Gladiators. That's fine. We'll probably get our Phalanx Pikemen in there to deal with those, because they're a little hard to take down with Falksmen. The Falksmen do not have 2 HP. You know, they do have armor piercing, but they're not quite the best candidates to take out Samnites. So we're getting in some pretty intense fighting with our Falksmen here. The Falksmen are cleaning up the city streets very nicely. I like to use Falksmen. I don't know. Falksmen are like cavalry to me. They're auxiliary troops that you want to deplete first. And they're very effective on the attack, but defensively they're not that effective. And your Phalanx Pikemen I like to keep guarded. I like to make my Phalanx Pikemen not take these casualties unless they have to. It's kind of my thought process. And anyway, we're going to move up the Phalanx Pikemen to assist the Falksmen, because they are fighting some Samnite Gladiators, so they may not have a good time. We'll see. They are starting to lose quite a few men, so perhaps this was not the best idea. But if we can get these Phalanx Pikemen up here soon. There we go. There's some routing, so these guys should hopefully rout before they take too many casualties. Hopefully soon. You know, they're shaken. They are very tired, though, so their combat is a little less effective, I believe. I don't know. I don't really know what tiredness does besides slow movement, if it actually affects combat performance or not. If it does, it's not drastically, I know, but, and get this Phalanx Pikes in here to assist. That first unit of Falksmen really is losing a lot of men. Kind of unfortunate, but, even with their armor upgrades and stuff. Sound of Cry Command, just in case they thought about routing, which they shouldn't. And they are taking out quite a few of the Samnite Gliders. The unit is almost dead. And I'll put down the Phalanx here and then just move forward. And now they decide the route, I guess. So that's fine. And have our Falksmen chase them a little bit. But we want to pull out our Falksmen, because they will not do very well against a full unit of Samnites. So we will have to pull out from there. And then we're going to pull our other Phalanx Pikemen in through here. And we should be able to take out these Samnites without too much trouble at all. And yeah, then we should be able to take the town of Salona back from the Romans after they took it from us so drastically. And then Drenis II here was able to take out their commander in a glorious battle. And now we're taking out the rest of their army in a glorious siege assault. If they didn't split up their forces, they might have stood a better chance against Drenis II, but I don't think they would have won. Although, you never know. And I'm going to take another drink. Be right back. And as you see, our Phalanx Pikemen are doing pretty good against these guys. They are losing a decent amount of men, but, you know, it is a siege assault. So always lose more men than you normally would, is the general rule. And there we go. Finish them off. Almost. There we go. There we go. Clear victory and 300. Yeah, we had more kills than we had losses, so that's fine. That's generally a sign of a good siege assault when you have more kills than losses. So I'm happy with it. And that means we take the town of Salona, which is very nice. That means we have all of northern Greece under our control, basically. And now we just have to take the Greek cities in the south, and we have total control of the Greek peninsula, which is very cool. And we're going to combine these units here, and we're going to send... we're going to send Drenus II northward. We're going to leave that one unit of two phalanx pikemen there. And we're going to train some militia hoplites. And that should be fine. The Julii, as you see, do have some large cities up there. And again, we're going to combine those two commanders' forces and then attack at Batavia. But we're going to save that for next time. Thanks for watching, guys. And in the next episode, hopefully we can take Corinth, perhaps take Thermon as well, and go and attack Batavium. So thanks for watching. Brain Lord signing out. Have a nice day. Ooh, wow.